it really isn't important to win the title for a third time simply because it doesn't make your credibility more valid. But I entered because I really wanted to. I wanted to see how much I've improved over the years. And it's just a great personal challenge for me. And I just enjoy doing it.
Well, here's a movie star. Because she was in the movie Pumping Iron 2, and I know you saw that film.
It hasn't been.
Yeah. That's why I know you saw the early go.
Yeah.
Rachel, the 1980 and 1982 Miss Olympia champion. We're going to enjoy her routine right with you at home.
Rachel puts a lot of drama into her routine. She really studies, probably more than any other competitor, the choreography and the music management involved. She is always extremely effective here.
Very serious poser. Mm-hmm. Lynn, let me ask you, is she the best known among women bodybuilders throughout the country?
Yes, she's probably the most highly marketed bodybuilder, and that makes her the best known. She also has probably would be next to Carla in numbers of prestigious titles won.
What about animosity? Is there any among the women? Surely there must be. I remember when I refereed, there was animosity. Coaches, there's animosity. How do they feel about Rachel?
There's a lot of mixed feelings about Rachel. You either, you know, love her or you hate her.
This is the crab, as they call it.
Uh-huh.
Competition. Well, now she's starting to smile. So it was all planned. You start out serious and then let the audience and judges a little bit.
She's very effective.
So look at those eyes. Looks like she has flexibility. Is that important? Bodybuilding?
Yes, Rachel is leaves no stone untouched. She's a very intelligent bodybuilder in her training and also in her presentation. She thinks about everything.
Well, she'll be one of the finalists.
Oh, definitely. Definitely. I think she looks better than I've ever seen her look before. She has better muscular development and more leanness and hardness than ever. She could pull it off again this time.
She's got a great routine going. Mm-hmm. Rachel McLeish, we talked to her. She describes how she choreographs her routines. Goes off the wrong way, we'll talk to her.
Well, I think basically I always have to change my style. They're always videotaped, and the judges are always looking for something different because they've seen it before. So First of all, I have to be inspired by the music and then pick poses that enhance my body.
Who picked out your music? How long did you take to pick out the routine? You explain.
Well, I usually have different, you know, friends scouting around for music. They kind of know what I like. I tell them, it's got to be kind of inspirational. It's got to be something really full of emotion. It's got to be this. It's got to be upbeat. It's got to have crescendo. It's very difficult to find one piece. So what I did is condense the 7-minute piece into, you know, 2 minutes, and that was pretty tough. But it's very difficult to find one piece that has it all.
It's ironic. I don't know if you watch ESPN, but that's our Sports Center theme.
What I just posted?
That's right.
Oh, how great.
Hey, good luck.